Hi, you're watching VSDC channel. If you're a big fan of Star Wars, this tutorial is for you. We're about to make a lightsaber effect. Yes, you heard it right. To recreate this legendary effect, you'll need footage where someone is using a stick or a blade. We'll later turn it into a lightsaber. If you already have the video, let's get started. Launch VSDC and hit Import Project to upload the footage with the original frame per second rate. Or you can start with a blank project and set the desired frame per second rate if you want to. In this case, make sure that the FPS rate of the project equals the FPS rate of your footage. With that in mind, let's finally get to the editing part. Make a right mouse click on the video and create a movement map. This effect is achieved due to several tracking points. It's the same principle we used in our recent tutorial about masking. You can watch it here if you want to. So, the handle of the lightsaber, or the hilt, will be our first tracking point. The end of it will be our second tracking point. To get started, select the hilt and launch the motion tracker by hitting Start Analysis. Then repeat the same steps for the end of the lightsaber. Save both movement maps to the project folder. Keep in mind that their names will differ. Next, select the free shape tool. Place the first control point on the hilt and the second one on the end of the lightsaber. Then open the free shape. Select the first control point, the one on the hilt, and make a double click. Switch to the Editor tab and add a movement map from the Video Effects menu. Repeat the same steps for the second control point. Go back to the main screen and select the free shape you've created. Then, open the Properties window and find the following settings. Pen Thickness. We recommend increasing this parameter to your taste. For our example, we'll set the value of 15. Next, select White as the color of the outline. Alright, for now we have footage of our character using what in a couple of minutes will become a lightsaber. Moving on, make a double click on the free shape, open the editor and add a Gaussian blur from the Video Effects menu. Set the blur level at 10 or higher if you want to. All we need to achieve is a mild blur effect. Go back to the main timeline tab and convert the free shape into a sprite. In the sprite settings, select the following parameters. Uses container? No. Show effects? Yes. Fill background? No. Then open the sprite and duplicate the free shape. Move the copy one layer below without changing it. Make another copy . Move it to the lowest level and select the color of your lightsaber in the Properties window. In our case, it's green. Duplicate the green lightsaber once again and move the copy to the lowest layer without changing it. And one more time, copy the green lightsaber, move it to the lowest layer on the timeline, open it, click on the Gaussian blur effect and increase the blur level to 40. If you really like this effect, guess what? You can make another copy of the last layer and increase the Gaussian blur levels to 80. Now that you know how to create your own lightsaber, young Padawan, may the Force be with you. If you liked this tutorial, give it a thumbs up and subscribe. The next video is coming in a week. Stay tuned.